Bonjour, hello, welcome at CCS. My name is Bas, I'm the owner of Il Magistrale Cycling Coffee, and I'm going to help you a little bit with a tutorial about the Rocket machine. We have a Rocket Appartamento here, we have the Fausto grinder, and these are amazing machines. I think every cycling cafe, every cycling connecting house or associated house should have a Rocket inside. And we really love those machines. They're also really connected to cycling, so that's great. And we roasted a special coffee. It's called the El Tractor. The El Tractor is the nickname of Tim de Klerk, the Belgian rider that rides for the Koenig Quickstep. And he gave him the nickname El Tractor because he was always pulling the peloton. He's always the front man, really chasing all the getaways. So it's really nice. Coffee's coming from Colombia, Brazil and Kenya. So it gives a lot of chocolate flavors, but also some peach from Colombia. There's a bit of peach citric flavor in there. And the Kenyan beans, they give a really nice aftertaste. So a little bit of blueberries. So we think you will like it from the Rocket machine. First, and it's really important, with all the other machines, we use the Brita. The Brita is our filter. We add water from the tap from the kitchen. We put it in the Brita. We let it rest for a while and it will be filtered and it's much better. The taste of the coffee will be much better. So on the top, there's a lid and we pour the water in. Not completely full. There's a little arrow. Yes. It should be great. So, what's important is first the grinder. You need to grind the coffee, of course, for the machine. So, what we're using is we're always using the double one. There is a single one in the basket. You can use it if you like. We love the double one because the flavors of a double porter filter is much better than a single porter filter. And I would suggest just make a coffee for someone else if you don't drink two coffees at a time or not a double espresso. So we add it here. There's an R of Rocket on the grinder. You push it and there's the sign of the double coffee, the double dose. And it's on 13 seconds now. We adjusted it especially for the El Tractor coffee. So here we go. Nice and slow, it winds really well. One, there we go. So, just hit it a bit. We have a special distribution tool here for you. So you can put in, turn it a few times. You have the temper, just push it. And look at it, looks nice. Before using the machine, always flush it. It's really important. If you do not flush the machine, the water is boiling, and when boiling water hits the coffee grounds, it will be very bitter in taste. So always flush the machine before you use it. Then you add it like this. You take two cups, of course. We have two espressos here, and open it up. It takes a while, around 7 seconds, and then the coffee, here it is, it starts flowing. It's normal, so don't worry, it's a normal process, and it's very nice. It's not automatic, so you need to push the lever back. If you think it's enough coffee, if you think, oh, I need a ristretto, just push it back. I think for now it's okay. It's around 28 seconds. I was counting in my hand actually. We have a great, can you see it? Yeah, it's a great espresso. Yeah, the taste is really nice. It's really, because of the pressure of the machine, you get a really nice coffee. Yeah. Oh, it's amazing. So, we put these away. After brewing the coffee, you Ik houd de fotofilter. We hebben cloth hier. Screamed a bit. And we have a special knockbox. Just hit it. Clean it. And let me see. Use this one. It's really easy. Just brush it out. All the old coffee particles are going out. Perfect. Put it there. And here this one. Because I'm also going to show you how to make a cappuccino. So, same process again. I like cappuccinos that I have a really more like a coffee flavor. So again, I use the double dosing. And I get it from the cupboard. The big cups, the cappuccino cups. Perfect. 30 seconds again. Do the same. Distribute it. Little damp, not too much. You don't need to push it through the cupboards. Okay. Rinse it again. As always, you put it in. There's a bit of coffee in there. Open it up. And now, you need to wait. So first we make the coffee, then we create a milk. You can also do it the other way around if you want first to have the milk and then the coffee. It's just what you like. So, we got this milk from Carrefour, yeah, from the village, from the main square. Lait frais entier, it's okay. Maybe you can also try another milk. We only drink this one because I like fresh milk. But there we are. But I think if you use the longer the milk that is longer fresh, it will also be probably good. But the most important is, if you look at the back, there is matière grasse, so the fats, and those are the important one, and this one is 3.6. So 3.6 grams of fats are in the milk, and it should be at least 3.6, even 3.8 would be even better. But I couldn't find that in the supermarket, so this was my best option, and it was fresh. So we put it in the milk jug. Just halfway, it depends on the amount of cappuccinos you want to make. So we have our coffee, I put it here. When you start steaming your milk, always same as with the coffee. So open it, push the steam out, otherwise it will burn a bit. And then put it in and put it on an angle of 45 degrees. Open it fully. And the steam pipe has to be in the coffee, in the milk, of course. Deep enough. Just keep your head. So now it's getting really hot on my hands. Just hit it a bit. Clean, always clean this one because the milk is terrible for your coffee machine. Also open it again. Now it's clean. Just do a little bit of extra cleaning. For the video shoot, of course. So here we are. Important, don't pour the milk directly. Start swirling it. And the milk is going round and round and round and round in the jug until it starts to shine a bit. So turning, turning, turning. Looks great. It's a bit thin, but I'm going to try it. Making a cappuccino, you always pour it really high. So we do it like this, because it falls through the coffee. Then we go down, and then you can make the cappuccino. So I don't know if you can see it. We have a little bit of a heart in there. It looks nice. And also, I would say it also tastes nice, but then I need to try it, of course, so. Yeah, the fresh milk, for me, yeah, it's necessary, the fresh milk, so it's nice. So, great. Again, open it up, we clean it. Use the brush. Back in the machine, you flush it coffee particles out of the system, and then we clean it again. If you're going to make a lot of coffees, just see what's happening, but in the end, it's best for the coffee and the taste of the coffee. If you just clean it, if you clean the milk and everything, then it will be perfect, and also for the next time. Otherwise, you need to start cleaning before you can use the machine. And it's a great machine, especially for the espresso, for the cappuccino. If you compare it with the Jura that's also here, this one will be much better. We use different beans, of course, but this Rocket is much, much better, and also full of taste. I really like it. Adding beans, just remove the lid, of course. You can add some beans in here. So yeah, I think that's mainly it. One thing, we have this, and this is a naked water filter. If you really like to use it, if you always wanted to use one, we have one here in the basket. Just add the basket of the double water filter, put it in here, and I'll show you how you can lift it. If you know it, it's quite easy, but it's with everything. Just put the cup in here and just lift it up. This one's brand new, so it's a bit more hot. And it's really warm, so I need to do it like this. There it is. So you remove it. I clean it a bit, otherwise everything is dirty. And you just, that's the sound. You put it in here. Same procedure, so you do not need to adjust the grinder or whatever. Just grind a double espresso, put it in here, and it will look amazing if you make a coffee from there. So I will show you later on. Okay, I think that's mainly it, especially for the Rocket machine. Enjoy your stay here. It's an amazing area. I've cycled everywhere here, and it's really nice. Of course, Molve 2 is the big one here, but also the roads around it are really nice. And check out our website if you like to see what we are doing, or Instagram, which other coffees that we have. And for the rest, enjoy your time here, and we hope to see you again somewhere. Okay. Bye bye.